another session of quant. Again, we take a few questions and try to solve. A mixture of oil and water in a jar contains 32 liters of oil and 10 liters of water. A liter of oil is added and a liter of water is added to the new mixture. 40% new mixture is 24 liters. So 40% is 24 liters. So 40 into 4 into 6 is 24. So 100% is how much? So you get 60 liters. 40% is 24, so 100% will be 60. So total is 60, from which 32 and 10 were already present. So minus 42. So what we added is 18 liters. 42 was already present. So what we added is 18, and 18 is 2A because we added 2A liters. That means A will be automatically 9 liters. So answer will be 9. 7 erasers and 15 pencils are to be distributed among 8 students in such a way that each student gets at least one item. Anyone who gets more than 3 pencils cannot get more than 1 eraser, and anyone who gets more than 1 eraser cannot get more than 2 pencils. What is the maximum number of pencils that a student can get? Now think logically. I mean, you can, there are 8 people. So what is the maximum possible you can give? If I think about it, I can give all 15 pencils to one person and one eraser to each of the other 7 people. I can give one eraser to each of the other 7 people and 15 pencils to one. This satisfies all constraints given to you. So automatically the answer here will be 15. I mean, you need to look at the extreme case. Since I said maximum pencils, I'll check out maximum what can be given. It's possible to give all the pencils to one and one erasers to other. It'll satisfy the constraint. Sort of a trick question. A lot of information given to you, but you have to just think about it, understand the sum, and try to get the answer. 2 males and 2 females can do a work in 10 days. 6 males and 2 females. So if you check it out, if I put 4 males and 2 females together as one group, the second group is 4 males plus 2 females and then further 2 males, because there's 6 males and 2 females. Now the first person can complete a work in 10 days. I'll do by percentage method. So if you can complete a work in 10 days, basically 10% work per day. If you can complete a work in 8 days, basically 12.5% work day. You should be comfortable with calculating half to 1 by 12. You should know 1 by 8 is 12.5%. So that means this extra 2.5% is done by these 2 males. So these 2 males can do 2.5% work in one day. The extra 2.5 which is out here is done by these 2 males, because 4 males and 2 females can do 10% work. So 2.5% will be these 2 males. So automatically 4 males will do 5% work. 2 males 2.5, 4 males 5%. So we may know 4 males plus 2 females is 10%. From which 4 males do 5%, that means 2 females will do 5% work. So I've got the breakup of male and female. This is per day work. All this is per day work. Now we want 2 males and 4 females. So we know 2 males will be how much? 2.5% work, 2 males. 4 females will be 10% work, because 2 female is 5%, so 4 female is 10%. So together they do 12.5%, which is 1 upon 8. That means the time taken will be 8 days to complete the work. So this is percentage method. You can do any other method also, but the key out here is to combine 4 males and 2 females together and keep these 2 males separately and then solve. So with that you can easily get the answer. Rectangle PQRS. So QR and RS, if you look at, RS is bigger than QR. So let's say, and draw a figure, right? RS 4 root 3, QR 4, P will come here. Then perpendicular, draw from P to meet QS. So if I draw perpendicular out here, point E, and diagonals intersect at point F. We want A of P E F. The moment you see a root tree and 4 and 4 root tree, you should make out it's a 36 inch angle. It's the first thing you should make out. So if this is 4 and a 4 root tree, that means we know QRS is 3690 or QPS also will be 3690. So which means this will be 60 degree. So this is 4, side opposite 90 is 4, side opposite 60 will be 2 root 3 and side opposite 30 will be 2. Side opposite 60 will be 2 root 3 and side opposite 30 will be 2. Also, if you look at a big triangle QRS, if side opposite 30 is 4, side opposite 90 will become 8. So this whole QS diagonal will be 8. Okay, because side opposite 30 is 4, side opposite 90 will become 8 in a 36 inch angle. So automatically FS is half of it, which will be 4. So FE will be 4 minus 2, which is 2. Now I can find the area of a triangle. So triangle PEF is half into FE into EP, which is half into 2 into 2 root 3, which will give you 2 root 3. The key is to understand that there's a root 3 out there. Therefore, it should be a 36 inch triangle. You can check it out by confirming it. Once you get that, then all the other three triangles become 36 inch triangle based on this. Just substitute the values. You can easily get the height PE and EF as the base. From that, you can find the area easily. So be comfortable with 45-45-90 and 36-90 triangles. A shift left 2 hours later in scheduled time. But to reach his destination 2,400 km away, he had to increase his speed by 33.33%. That means speed, the ratio of the old speed to new speed will be 3:4. He's increased by 33.33% means increased by 1/3. So the new speed is 4/3 times. So if I say old speed is 3, the new speed is 4, the ratio. So time ratio is 4:3. If the speed ratio is 3:4, more the speed, less the time, time ratio is 4:3. But we know the time is 2 hours. The difference in time is 2 hours. 4 and 3, the difference is 1. To make it 2, we'll have to make it 8 and 6. So this will be 8 hours and this will be 6 hours. So we want the new increased speed, which is 6 hours. That means it covers 2,400 kilometers in 6 hours. Which will be 400 kilometers per hour. The 400 is the speed. So ratios are important. If you can get the ratio, that also is a good way of trying to solve the sums. Right? I hope it's clear. Right. Thank you.